What it do, homies? It's your boy Dave, and I'm back today. We are here with a reaction from Opeth, a reaction to Opeth called Windowpane. Now, my most recent song of theirs that I did a reaction to, I can remember, was called Harvest. And one thing that I enjoyed about that was their ability to expressively and audibly write the lyrics in a sense that makes you wonder, you know what I mean? Like, it definitely stimulates the imagination. That's what I got from Harvest, especially coupled with the music video that they kind of had, was kind of gave it like a fall, kind of haunting, harrowing Halloween kind of feel, right? So I'm expecting some of the same things here while we check out Windowpane. So let's go ahead and shut up and turn it up. Got the lyrics up so we don't miss anything. You do have it in English and Spanish. Tempo. Jump in. So that intro right there, that kind of gives you like a sense of wonder, especially with the you know, one, two, I think it's either a quarter note, it may have been a half note, and the fact that they just let it ring, you know, while it was ringing, while you heard like the after effects of the note, they just went doo-doo-doo-doo. That kind of gives you a sense of like wonder and maybe like imaginative, like daydreaming almost, just because of the way that guitar just sound doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, and then it just revs back up doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, like these dreams, right? These dreams of daydreaming. I'm almost kind of thinking of like window shopping, the type of stuff you experience when you're window shopping. It's like progressively walking slowly through all of these things that you're seeing and just hoping or something like that. And this is just before we get into the lyrics. I couldn't be absolutely wrong. I just wanted to kind of jump in on that, what that intro was sounding like to me before we took off here. So blank face in the window pane, made clear in seconds of light, disappears and returns again. Like mannequins. Counting hours, searching the night. Solo already? Guitarlo already. Okay, so it's interesting that it sounded like it was strings right at the beginning before the solo came in. Based off what he just said with the blank faces in the window playing, you know, appearing seconds in light and disappearing again, right? So imagine the strings that's coming in kind of giving you that blank faces that are appearing in the window playing, and then he's in seconds and then disappearing again. So it said it's coming like flash, appearing in flash in just seconds, and then it disappears. So the seconds, then imagine the strings, although it's not necessarily seconds, but you saw how short that was in comparison to the solo that was going on. And then the solo start playing, kind of giving me a sense of, okay, there goes the disappearance, right? And with this disappearance probably becomes maybe confusion or maybe loneliness, because I'm kind of getting that kind of sense from what we're hearing in his music. It's also kind of giving me a definitely like laid back kind of, what do you want to call it? Like, it's not necessarily barbecue jam, but I don't know what else to call it. It's definitely one of them songs you probably listen to if you're your heartbreak. Like, I just see you sitting there chilling on a window with a smoke or something, just rocking in your chair, just reflecting. You know what I mean? Window panes, reflecting. Okay, go back. Might be waiting for someone. Might be there for us to see. Might be a little talking. Yeah. So there it goes again. Okay, so I learned that they do it for 16 measures, right, with the strings before they jump in. Now, what was interesting about that, it's kind of like a call and response, right, whether they either put an echo on it, but it didn't sound like an echo because I think one of them played a step down after he did it. But regardless, now I'm sitting here thinking of Windowpane. I'm thinking of sitting here looking into like a mirror and you looking at the reflection of your soul, right? So that call and response that we heard on that solo was interesting because we're essentially looking at a copy of ourselves when we look at a mirror. So that call and response is like, hey, here I am, and then here I am. Now, if I'm correct, and I might go back and look at it, it looks like it wasn't necessarily an echo per se. It was probably played by a second guitar to lead in the second one. It's just that the second response sounded like it was a step down. So let's go back and listen to that again. Okay, no, it's the same notes that are being played, but that end of that, the response to that call, how it just went into that do-do-do-do-do-do, it kind of was like, kind of give a sense that if you look at yourself through the mirror and you see something that you don't like, that it's like that reflection is lashing back out at you. So you hear that fall. What is going on here, man? This is what I'm saying, man. This is Opeth, y'all. Y'all listening to those drums? Third voice of the children cry. There goes again, call and response. I think it goes into a minor key. Step up, my thing. Thank you. the intro. Now, towards that beginning, we kind of got symptoms of we see the reflections, right? Because right now I'm starting to think that this is more of a reflection of your inner soul, like a window pane into your soul, right? Or into your spirit, maybe. Maybe that's what I'm getting. Towards the beginning of that solo, we kind of definitely got some more evil, haunting, harrowing sounds, right? And then it kind of opened up into, it's almost like you looking inside and you seeing the ugly inside. And then it kind of progressively went towards more of a more angelic, more heavenly of a sense. It even had some type of astral kind of sound to it, because there was some space, there's some texture in the notes, kind of saying like, hey, I'm trying to either like rise above this ugliness or this disgustingness that I don't like to see in my soul, and return back to, you know, the normal me, the normal self, which would explain their movement into, you know, to play the intro, you know, the same, you know, same melodies doing at the intro right back. It's like, all right, I'm normal now. So that last solo was more of like a journey into your soul to discover the ugly and then to slowly remove it, which would explain those angelic kind of pads and what stuff that we heard, kind of give it like that space, that internally kind of sound. And now we're back to normal. You know what I mean? It was a journey. That's what I got from that one. Covering secret scars. It's definitely an eternal thing. His hand is waving a goodbye. There's no response or action return. There is deep prejudice in me. Oh. Outshines a reason inside. Okay, well, that last line right there, there's deep prejudice in me. Give me a second. I need to go. I just want to take a look at this. Hold on. There's deep prejudice in me. Okay, so don't really have an opinion or anything about something, not based on what I'm giving. Huh? Okay, so it's almost like it's a sense of. Let me see. Because I had to, before I form my thoughts, I had to look up prejudice. You know, I heard the word. You know, I've used it a couple of times, but for some reason I couldn't remember the definition. Preconceived opinion that is not based on reason or actual experience. So it's almost like You're more scared of. If this actually is a song that has something to do with the internal self, it's more like you're more scared of the things that could happen versus the things that are actually happening, right? That's where he says, "Given dreams all riddled with pain." Basically, you're taking these prejudices and everything, and you're solidifying them, you're making them real inside your soul. So therefore, you're having these dreams about it. Let's see, projected onto the last. So you're prejudiced ways or anything about soul is projected onto the last, meaning that it's either projecting into like the last of your soul or the last person that you just met. This song might have been deeper than I thought. I don't know. Now I have no idea what I'm talking about. I mean, I still think it's an issue with the soul or an issue with oneself, but that's what I'm thinking. That kind of just threw me for a loop right there, that there's deep prejudice in me. Because first I thought, I was like, yeah, I got this song figured out, and then they just do that for a loop. There was another part where he said to the hand waving goodbye. Is that like more of a sense of you waving goodbye to yourself, or whatnot. Because at first, when he said that, I was like, oh, is this a song about somebody's passing? I'm not sure. The only thing that I am sure about is that this has something to do with either discovering oneself, or you're looking inside somebody else, trying to get rid of the darkness, or as he said, the prejudice inside of you, and maybe turn it into a better place, right? And also, before we close this video, how about them drums, man? Right? Them switching tempos a lot. You know, when you first start learning percussion, there's a certain tempo that that you need to master to be able to play ambidextrous, right? And it's kind of, you got the bass that goes like do do, right? Do do, and then you hit a hi hat, do do do, and then you have the snare just pop pop. Now those are basic techniques, but when you're first starting off, that's super hard to learn. The reason why I say that is because the intro, you know, I'm pretty sure maybe any experienced drummer can do it, but it's just the constant switching throughout the entire song, which is very interesting. We even got a little bit of drum solos, right? The drum lows. We even got a little bit of that in the end, in the middle of the solo, I believe, to kind of think, kind of give it a sense of no rhythm, because it was no rhythm section at all. It was like one of those things where, all right, this is like a reflection, so let's just take some time, cut off all the backtrack, and let's just think about it, right? The drums kind of give me a symbol, symbolizing like the thinking process of everything that's going on, because thinking is complicated, right? It can be on one track, then it can switch, and that's what we got, right? We had at the intro, we had kind of like a standard thinking, and then it kind of transitioned into all the kinds of things that maybe were what were causing these issues within oneself, and then towards the end, and we kind of went back to the standard thinking, right? Yo, what am I talking about right now? I don't know, man. This type of stuff that goes in my head. I like to dive into the songs and find out, why am I hearing this? Why did the artist choose this? Everything down from the simple one note, which one you're playing, what drum pattern, are you going to let the cymbal crash? Are you going to have a tight hi-hat? Are you going to let it loose? And then once the artist made that decision, why did they make that decision? Once you start looking at songs like that, you start enjoying it a lot better. Then go back through it and just listen to it as a whole. Another amazing song by Opeth. That's the end of this video. If you enjoyed the content, leave a like and subscribe. Dave's out.